In this video, I would love to show you 7 questions that I get asked very often as a vegan. And yeah, the first question is, what is veganism? So veganism basically means that you don't eat animal products. So you don't eat milk, you don't eat cheese or meat, fish, eggs, honey and stuff like that. So yeah, and actually there's a difference between plant-based and vegan, because plant-based is more only the diet, so people don't eat animal products mostly for health reasons. And veganism is basically everything, so it's the lifestyle. You don't try, you don't want to cause harm, you try to not buy or use cosmetics that were used on animals or tested on animals, and you don't try to buy leather and stuff like that. So it goes even more. So veganism is like this whole lifestyle. So why would people go vegan? Actually, there is a lot why people could or should go vegan, because it's so amazing, but I will keep it short. So basically, there are three reasons. The first one is health reasons, the second one is environment, and the third one is animals. Because people who go vegan understand that the consumption of animal products will cause harm and suffering to all those three, so health, animals, and environment. And that's why people just go vegan. So the next question is, is veganism too expensive? And the answer is no, because you make veganism as expensive as you want to make veganism. So if you buy a lot of extra protein and buy a lot of super grass and super smoothies, stuff like that, well, it can get very expensive. But my opinion is that you don't really have to buy all of those fancy stuff. And then it's super cheap. I mean, all those basic food elements like bread, pasta, rice, beans, lentils, a lot of vegetables are actually super cheap, so it's not expensive. And if you want to, buy organic meat or organic eggs, they can be very expensive. So you make your diet as expensive as you want to make it, but in general, a vegan diet does not have to be expensive. So the next question is, what do vegans eat? And this question is super funny, because before I turned vegan, I actually thought that vegans would be super malnourished, would only eat grass or leaves. But this is not the case at all, because there's so much variety you can eat. And yeah, because there's, bread, pasta, rice, and also a lot of different sorts of fruit and vegetables. And I bet that you have not eaten every vegetable that is in the supermarket or every fruit that is in the supermarket. So there's, a huge variety. And you must not forget that, for example, in India are living about 300 million people, almost vegan. So, and they survive, and there's so much variety. And the funny thing is that a lot of meat eaters are actually not having that much variety as they think they have, because, for example, if they eat bread with cheese or bread with meat or sausage, there are so many different varieties of cheese. However, everything comes from milk, and it's the same with meat. There are so many different varieties of meat. However, everything is in the end meat, so there's not so much variety that people eat often on a standard American diet. And yeah, but I agree with you, in the beginning it might be a change and you might have to Google some vegan recipes, but there are so many vegan recipes out there. Just try it. The next thing is, where do I get my protein? And this is a huge question. I get this question so many times. And I think it's really funny, because first of all, I think we have to put our focus away from quantity and back to quality. Because when we grow up, we are babies and we have to grow a lot to get very tall, we consume our mother's breast milk. And what's really interesting, this breast milk has only about 1-2% of protein in it, so the protein percentage is very low. And that's basically when we have to grow very big and huge. And now we are adults and we don't have to grow so much, so we don't actually need so much protein. And also when you want to build a lot of muscle, you still don't need so much protein, you know? And so yeah, we have to go back from quantity to quality. And with quality, I mean the protein that our body can best assimilate, because our body can actually not assimilate, you know, cooked animal protein so good, because the cooked animal protein will, you know, change the structure of the protein, and so our body cannot assimilate as good, and hence the protein will clog our arteries, and it will be very difficult for our blood to run through the arteries, and this will lead to cardiovascular diseases. So yeah, and the last thing about protein is that actually everything has protein. So if you're still concerned about the quantity of protein, I just want to say that, you know, if you eat a banana, or if you eat an apple, or if you eat a carrot, or if you eat eggs, or if you eat pasta or lentils, and everything is protein. And the last thing is that, you know, I'm not eating meat for 8 years now, and no, for six years now, and I'm vegan for 4 years now, and I still do a lot of sports, and I still do a lot of bodyweight exercises, and yeah. So you can do a lot of sports and you can build muscle when you're vegan. Yeah. And how long will I do this diet? That's the next question. I really hope that I will be able to do this diet for a very long time, because it has helped me so much with my weight, and it has, you know, transformed my life so positively. So I really hope that I will stick to this vegan diet and just continue doing it, because I love it so much. It has improved my life so much. And the last question, the very last question is, what should I do if I want to become vegan, but my parents just don't let me go vegan? First, remember that your situation will pass, and there are a lot of people who experience the same for you. So just, you know, keep going. The second thing is, know that it is your body and you decide what you put in your body. So if you decide, I don't want to eat meat, you don't have to eat meat. It's your body. The next thing is, just remind yourself that your parents just want to your best, you know? They want you to be healthy. And there's so much wrong stigma about veganism that it might be, you know, not good for health or something like that. So just understand your parents and do a lot of research, and just show your parents information and stuff like that, to just show them that veganism is actually quite beneficial for health. And the last thing is, be the example, because people learn the best by example. And just by showing that you do sports and you eat a vegan diet, just shows them that a vegan diet is great. So thank you so much for watching. Have a nice day or evening. Ciao.